Hello, I'm Dr. Dennis Bordet. I'm a chair of the Department of Neurology at Oregon Health and Sciences University and executive director of the Multiple Sclerosis Center at OHSU. And this is my colleague.
Hi, I'm Rebecca Spain. I'm one of the MS neurologists and one of the study investigators using lipoic acid.
And we're going to talk to you today about lipoic acid and its potential role in treating progressive multiple sclerosis. So several years ago, I became interested in testing antioxidants in an animal model of MS to see if we could find one that was effective in the MS-like disease that occurs in mice. And the first antioxidant that we tested was lipoic acid. And it was remarkable at how effective it was. It was completely able to prevent and to treat this mouse model of MS. And because of the spectacular effectiveness of the lipoic acid, we began to initiate experiments in people with MS. And our early studies showed that lipoic acid could be given safely to people with MS, and also allowed us to determine what the proper dose was.
It's a 2-year-long study with 56 participants, half of whom get oral lipoic acid, half of whom get placebo. The main outcome measure is MRI, and we're seeing how the MRI changes over 2 years. But we are also looking at a number of other things, including an eye test and some walking and balance measures. We also draw some blood during the course of the study. We hope to get 56. We have 20 enrolled so far, and time is of the essence for getting everyone enrolled in the study, because even after we enroll the last person, it still will take 2 years to complete, and then we have to analyze the data. It's really important to be studying lipoic acid. It's an inexpensive medication available over the counter, but we'll never know whether it's truly effective or not until we do a rigorously designed trial such as this.
There's something else. There's something else that is special about OHSU and our MS research program. All of us that are involved with studying MS believe that we're only going to conquer MS as a team. And that team includes basic scientists, clinician scientists such as Dr. Spain, and it also includes the people with MS who step forward and volunteer to participate in our research studies. It also includes people with MS, their loved ones, their friends, and other people in the community who step forward and donate money in support of our research. We're only going to be able to conquer this tough disease, MS, if we work together as a team. And our commitment is to be there for our patients and for people with MS until we've conquered it.
I would like to encourage anyone who has MS in the Northwest area to participate in research projects here at OHSU. I think you'll find that all the researchers and their assistants are very helpful and friendly people. They're so appreciative of you coming up here and participating in their projects. And in addition, even though your participation in one of their ongoing projects may not help you right now, it will help somebody with MS in the future. And I feel a real obligation to that. All the ABC drugs and the new medications that are coming out now are out there on the market only because other people with MS helped participate in those. So I would really like to encourage everyone who has MS in the Northwest area to call OHSU, come up here, and help be part of the new research happening. Thank you so much.